Good morning, everybody. It is currently 7:32 a.m. Hope you all slept well, or for those who are still awake, hope you had a good day. So we're gonna play some Satisfactory. So I've been playing this a lot, and let me tell you, I made some major improvements since the last time I did my first video. Oh, the improvements I made. You're gonna be blown. Oh yeah, so, this Friday, Call of Duty Black Ops Cold War drops, and as soon as I wake up, I will be playing it. The first thing we have right here is my new awesome weapon. It is the Xeno Basher, included with the rebar gun. I think I already had the chainsaw. So first off, I did fill the giant space elevator. I'm actually pretty close to getting done with what I need to get done with it to unlock tier 2 stuff. Or tier, let's see, 5 and 6, I think. And this is the last mission I gotta do for the hyper tubes. So we're gonna go ahead and make a bunch of this copper stuff we need. I got so much copper bar lying around that it's not funny. Okay, but I don't have enough for that apparently, so we're gonna remodify one of our machines. And I've been doing this with actually a lot of the machines, is modifying them to input special need stuff. So as you can see here, I have one storage unit full of the steel stuff. And then this storage unit over here, wherever it may be placed at, it was actually filled with another material to make the versatile framework. And we have 22. We should have gotten at least 100. But then when I need to do normal craft work, like let's say I need to make normal plates, well, this is stuff to make either plates or the rotaries normally. But with this, I can actually inject two other substances, cut off the turn off the machines, and just do this. So that is so much better than constantly making new factories. And we're gonna try to do that up here too, so that way I can make everything a little bit more efficient. Oh yeah, and now I can make coal out of wood. Versus having to find it, and I get so much wood that I use for the biofuel that this will have to go by a lot faster now. So down over there, I actually have my coal factory. I did unlock that finally, thank God. Okay, and I have been mass producing copper wiring like crazy. Let's see. Oh wow, that's okay, that storage unit's already full. So what we're gonna do is come up here and we're gonna cut off all power to this machine right here. And then actually with this one, since I already had it set up like that, we're just gonna come up here and rechange our recipe to copper sheets. And there we go. And then when I want to start making wire again, I just reattach this to here. And there we go. Simple as that. So that way I won't have wrong product trying to go in here and having to mess with that. I could just start making copper wire again and just bing, bang, boom. And And I do have a facility over there now. I have several facilities. I'm very proud of that. Took me a while, but I did. I've unlocked some new MAME research since the last video. So I found hard drives. They're very tricky to find. We got ourselves a medical inhaler. I'm almost close to unlocking. This is actually something I need to make anyways, so I got to go down to the quartz, I think. Now I need 100 of the little trays of quartz. I only have 9. We're gonna try to make some more. Now, I haven't found a natural quartz mine. I'm hoping to. So that's kind of going to be what we're going to be hunting down today, is quartz for the quartz mine. And I have misplaced my buggy again. I did actually build a tractor. And set up a tractor route for a coal mine. So as you see there, there's my coal mine, there's the truck depot, there's another truck depot over there with the coal mine. And then I got a factory I built over there that's actually starting to look a little bit more like a factory every time I screw around with it. Now I'm going to do different levels of product. Like the first floor is obviously going to be all iron. Second floor will be maybe a mixture of copper and limestone. Haven't decided yet. Okay, we got a lot of concrete here. We'll just go put that in my storage unit. Hopefully. Let's go take a tour. Oh, I am almost out of fuel. Put 100 in you, and there we go. So this map is actually very huge. I didn't realize how big it was. I actually kind of got lost. If I hadn't put down beacons, I would have been lost. Yeah, I marked the pass by putting giant watchtowers. Out of fuel, our supply chain has been disrupted. There we go. Yeah, make sure to constantly keep these things fueled. If you don't, they will die on you. And that does suck. Now, coal is always in the most unfavorable of places. The further back you go, the better chances you have of finding pure coal on the ground. Where we're at, not so much. That's something I'm saying. Okay, we got some copper over here. That's nice. So we need quartz. Whatever the heck that thing is. I still haven't figured out what those are used for. Probably never will. And if we come up here, we have my steel factory that produces all the steel I need. Now, I will need a lot more steel, actually, so while we're here, we're gonna grab a bunch. Okay, so we're gonna need about 100, 2, 3, 4, 5. And bloop, 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 bloop. And then we'll take out another. Okay, so that's 1,000. see, I'll take out the biomass fuel, place that there. Okay, and bazinga. Okay, so we got 1,000, we need 2,400. And a cool thing you can do is actually if you hit X and go to like parts or anything, you can actually add to-do list here. And so that way you know how much of a material you need. If you keep clicking the add button, it will add on to it. So I had to click it 400 times to get to where I need it. So maybe in the future for the developers, if you can make it a type in. So like say I need to type in 500 of a certain thing instead of clicking 500 times. And maybe with the bench, just do a one-time click. Like a max button, some raft max, that might be helpful. Just a suggestion. So as you see here, now the cool thing about the coal miners is once you get a coal mine set up and water going to it, and if it's through a conveyor belt like this versus the truck system I have set up, you are set for life for power. I mean, this thing produces more coal than that thing can consume. So it's always backed up. I mean, look at this. This is completely full of coal. And as one goes out, one more fills it up. I kind of like doing that because I can also have storage I can actually grab from if I need it. Because again, it's producing more than I actually need to consume. And as you see, I got it split three ways. And I'm powering up my machine over here, too. So I've been doing a lot of this stuff lately. Now I am thinking about making either a dedicated server for YouTube and Twitch, and one for Twitch, where you guys can actually join in and come play the game with me and be on my videos. Would you be interested in that? Because I can actually set it up. It's still in early access, but I haven't found many bugs whatsoever. There were a few graphic bugs. They don't affect the game that much, but like you'll have your conveyor belt actually going through a rock, but it still works. So it's not like it's a game-breaking bug, but it's just like a little glitch. So that's just something I've known, or like pipes running through conveyor belts running through pipes, and it's just the small things. It's not really affecting gameplay, but it looks a little unpolished is all. But as far as groundbreaking bugs go, I have not found a single one. Knock it on artificial wood. Raw quartz in its purest form. Okay, that was the sword. I'm not used to the new sword sound. Okay, let's look for more raw quartz. That one is 1,000, 2,000. Okay, I guess we're heading this way. See, having this little vehicle makes it so much easier. Now, you can't sadly use that from here. But if you do hit the same button, you do get like autopilot, hide paths, and stuff like that. does actually shoot out blue fire, which actually does more damage to me. That thing's poison. So if you attack it, it will shoot out poison at you. Get out of the mystical forest of getting screwed. Things are actually not that expensive to make, but I really don't want to lose it. Okay, so I assume we need to get down there. Well, oakley dokley. I know exactly how to get down there safely. Oh yeah, if you run over the animals, they actually don't die. I actually thought they did, and I dragged one of the alphas back without realizing it. And it pretty much killed me as soon as I got out of the vehicle. Because I was afraid to blow one out. Now in this area, for some reason, there are a lot of those little toxic spores. Surrounding is okay. Please tell me it's not all the way down there. That's not going to be a happy camper. There's a mouthful down there, if I remember correctly. Now they will actually, the alpha will follow you down and attack your vehicle, so be careful with that alpha creature. And always keep a little check there on your fuel. Wow, this is majestic. It's beautiful. I love it. We love it. Okay, that is uranium. Apparently there's uranium in the game. Interesting. Who knew there was uranium? I didn't. Until now. Since obviously I don't have the proper suits or stuff, I'm not even gonna touch that 50-foot hole. I will definitely remember this cave. And since it's that way, I can actually set up a factory there. And hopefully nuclear power will be better than regular power. Say though, those creatures there are very eerie looking, and I love it, because you only find them in these creepy places. to go. I do not know how to repair a vehicle hull at all. Okay, there is another graphic bug right there. Okay, we got an ominous red glow. Interesting. Leave my vehicle alone. I'll tell you what. Ooh, okay, I think we're about to get out of the cave. I think we definitely passed the red quartz that we need. Yep, there's the entrance. Or one of the many entrances. And we got a bunch of power slugs that you can actually make special devices to run in overpower mode. To mark my spot, I am going to build a watchtower, lookout tower. That way I remember that, hey, if I actually need to do come back this way, the lookout tower is my goal. I always try to put them near the actual entrances to the places versus just at a random off-site location. I love the way this looks. It's just eerie. Looking to be discovered. Okay, we got a massive source of water right here. Now the little guys, they won't attack ya. Bigger guys, yeah. You know, I bet you once I get the radiation suit or whatever, I can actually go through that and actually get all the cool stuff from that. That'd have to be pretty cool. Okay, let's make a turn down here. Hunt for the red quartz. Okay, that's sulfur. I have a sulfur mine now, so I don't need to bother with that. I need yellow. You see that big one there? That's the Alpha. Or what I'm calling the Alpha. Since this game literally does not name these critters. Okay, this one's not attacking me. That's actually nice. Boom, 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 boom! Make it laugh. Okay, we got those big giant creatures. They are very harmless. They will not attack you. They will not kill you. And they won't damage you if you touch one. There's also a weird dog-like thing that actually you can pet. But I don't think they got the animation for it all worked out yet. Great, of course, the poisonous blocks. Just what I always wanted. It'd be really nice to find a red quartz mine somewhere, anywhere really. Like I said, this game map is so massive and huge. It's really beautiful, actually. Like I said, this is like No Man's Sky. Instead of going to multiple planets, though, you got one huge, massive planet. That's a little doggy thingy you pet. That little red thing. Oh wow, so there's a whole entire desert biome. That is just beautiful. Look at that. That is just breathtakingly beautiful. There are massive biomes everywhere. And I love them. And this is why it's so easy to get lost in this game. Nom, 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 nom. Okay, another note for developers, please put in a freaking emergency brake for these things. And as soon as you exit a vehicle, do not allow it to continue to drive off and waste fuel. It's done that before. If you go out of the vehicle that is still going pretty fast, it will definitely keep going and waste your fuel. Poison up there. There's a lot of poison everywhere. And I like these trees. They're beautiful. This whole game is beautiful. And like I said, this is still the early access, and this game is already this awesome. Imagine what it will be like when it's finished. It will truly be a sight of beauty. Okay, we're at the 27-minute marker there, so we'll start heading back. I did not see any red quartz anywhere. Kind of disappointing. Now, I don't know how to kill those things. Yeah, that will probably come with the rifle I'm trying to unlock. Nah, we're gonna head back. Okay, I see some sulfur there. Big, beautiful lake down there. So I can actually build a bunch of coal mines down there, probably. There's a bunch of coal. And just run the power to a main power grid. That look there. Kind of looks like bones of an animal coming out. Unless that is supposed to be bones. Either way, it's cool looking. I think I'm lost. Right. I should put down more power. Or at least another beacon. Okay, at least I know everything is about southwest. So if I can find paths that go southwest, that would really help out. Again, it's just so freaking easy. Get lost, but getting lost, you also find a lot of amazing things. And a lot of these places actually do loop in back into each other. Like, I went the completely different opposite way and wound up actually back at my base. Thingy to get across the lake. figuring that cement would come in handy. That's how you also gotta do a lot of things in here, is can make your own bridge. Or look for the La Naturelle bridge. Okay, let's see. Wonder if this takes me back to the cave, actually. If it did, then, that just kinda proves my point. Stupid tree. Made me look bad. And with the chainsaw, you can't cut down trees. And there are a lot of, eerie looking trees out there that are actual trees. These actually look pretty cool. Yeah. Oh, hi, sulfur. Okay, well, I can better see the space station, so I'm getting closer. Oh, little doggo. Oh, ho, ho, ho. What do we got here? These are... Oh, shit. You got... Come on. There's a freaking alpha there. I need those supplies. Fuck it. I guess we're gonna kill an alpha today. Along with several other critters. Nice. But, sadly, we're going to end the video here. I'll pick up part 3 here in a little bit. So, please subscribe and leave comments. And, as always, have a nice day. Live, love, and game on.